गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो एज वी आर डूइंग अवर चैप्टर नंबर 10 दैट इज एडेप्टेशन इन प्लांट्स एंड इन दिस चैप्टर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द टेरेस्ट्रियल प्लांट्स. देन आफ्टर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द एक्वाटिक प्लांट्स एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंसेक्टिवोरस प्लांट्स. सो जनरली स्टूडेंट एज इट नेम इज टेलिंग टू अस दैट इंसेक्टिवोरस प्लांट्स आर द प्लांट्स दैट आर कार्निवोरस इन नेचर एंड दैट आर दैट ईट द इंसेक्ट्स. They eat the insect and still generally these plants grow in the soil that has deficiency of nutrients. So there is a deficiency of nutrients in the soil, that's why they feed on the insects to fulfill the deficiency of nutrients. So let's discuss about these plants. The insectivorous plant, they are carnivorous in nature, means they eat the insects and their leaves are modified. In this plant, the leaves are modified to trap the insects, to catch the insects, and they are known as insectivorous plants because they trap the insects and feed the insects. Next, examples, if we talk about the examples of these insectivorous plants are the Venus flytrap and pigeon plant. So, these plants, these Venus flytrap and pigeon plants also have some modified leaves that help them to catch or trap the insects. So first one is the Venus flytrap. They have the leaves that are like boxes with hinges. Leaves are like this, in which hinges are present. Like this. The hinges are present and when the insect touch these leaves, these hinges shuts and catch the insects. So this is the modified leaves of the Venus flytrap, how they catches the insect. And the second is the pitcher plant. There are the leaves are in the form of container or in like a pitcher, matti ki tarah form mein hote hain, with a lid to cover the mouth of a pitcher. There is a lid is also present to cover the mouth of that pitcher or that container, and when the insect sits on the pitcher, the lid that is present on the pitcher, it closes down and the insect falls into the pitcher. And some digestive juices are also present inside the pitcher that helps in digestion of the insects that fall inside the pitcher. So these are the modifications that present in the leaves of the insectivorous plants, and these are the plants that eat the insects. So next category of the plant is the non-green plants. So students, generally we have discussed that all plants are green, but non-green plants are the plant that are saprophytic in nature. It means they do not prepare their food. It means they also do not have chlorophyll. They are non-green because they do not have the green color pigment, that is the chlorophyll, in their leaves. And if they do not have the chlorophyll, so they will not able to prepare their food. So plants that cannot make their food, they do not make their food and absorb nutrients from their plants. They absorb their nutrients from their plants, and animals are all saprophytic plants. So these are the plants that obtain their nutrition, their food from their plants and the animals. That's why they are known as saprophytic plants, and they are non-green because they do not have the chlorophyll that help them to prepare their food. So examples of these plants are the Indian pipe and the coral root. So if we talk about the pictures of these diagram here, you can see this is the picture of Venus flytrap. See the leaves. The leaves are like the comb like the structures are there, and the hinges are also there. When the insect sits on them, these leaves shut and catch the insect. Similarly in pitcher plant, see the leaves are like a pitcher, ek matki ki tarah hote hain, and when the insects come to the mouth of this pitcher, the leaves, that this lid closes down and this insect fall inside the pitcher, and there are some digestive juices present that help in digestion of the insects. The third or the next is the diagram of this Indian pipe. This is a saprophytic plant and this is a diagram of coral root. These are the diagram of or the picture of non-green plants or the saprophytic plant. So student, this is all about your today's class. Thank you and have a nice day.